Good morning, students. So far we have discussed the formation of discrete frequency distribution as well as we have solved few problems under formation of continuous frequency distribution. Today we will solve few more problems under formation of continuous frequency distribution. See, the following is the data regarding the IQ of 30 children of a school, and they have given in the class 90 to 110. This is the fifth stroke, so mark it diagonal. Next 116 is in the class 110 to 120. 93 will come in the class 90 to 110. 100 in the same class. 120 in the class more than or equal to 120. Next 100 in the class 90 to 110. 108 will also fall in the same class. 100 again in the same class. Fifth one, Marathi diagonal. 110 in the same class, because 110 is not included here. In the exclusive class, I give the upper limit and actually include part of the next class. I include part of it. So 110 to 120. Next 109 in the class 90 to 110. Next 117 is in the class 110 to 120. 98 in the class 90 to 110. 103 in the class 90 to 110. Next 99 in the same class, 110 in the class 110 to 120, 95 will come in class 90 to 110, 101 again in the same class, 105 will also fall in the same class, 98 is also in the same class. Now we will count the tally marks and write the frequency. So less than or equal to 90, 1. Next. 90 to 110, 5, 10, 15 plus 3 is 18. Next, 110 to 120, 5 plus 3 is 8. Next, lastly, more than or equal to 120, 3. So make the total write the class integrals one by one. So starting from 40 to 49. Next, 50 to 59. Next is 60 to 69. 70 to 79. 80 to 89. 90 to 99. 100 to 109. Next, 110 to 190. First value is 76. Will come in the class 70 to 79. Next, 40 is in the class 40 to 49. 67 in the class 60 to 69. 73 is in the class 70 to 79. 72 again in the same class. 77 will fall in the same class. 63 is in the class 60 to 69. 74 in 70 to 79. 50 will come in the class 50 to 59. 54 again in the same class. 80 in the class 80 to 89. 49 in the class 40 to 49. Next, 83 is in the class 80 to 89. 42 in 40 to 49. 84 in front of 80 to 89. 79 in 70 to 79. 70 in the same class. 66 is in the class 60 to 69. Next, 75 in the class 70 to 79. 78 in the same class. 76 also comes under the same class. 79 in front of 70 to 79. 69 in 60 to 69. 73 in the class 70 to 79. Next, 61 is in the class 60 to 69. Next, 95 is in the class 90 to 99. Next, 100 is in the class 100 to 109. 80 in the class 80 to 89. 64 in the class 60 to 69. 71 in the class 70 to 79. 41 in the class 40 to 49. 56 is in the class 50 to 59. 53 again in the same class. 104 in the class 100 to 109. Next, 42 is in the class 40 to 49. Next, 94 in the class 90 to 99. 150 in the class 100 to 119. 77 is in the class 70 to 79. 100 in the class 100 to 109. Next, 69 is in the class 60 to 69. 76 in the class 70 to 79. 78 in the class 70 to 79. Next, 82 in 80 to 89. 78 again in 70 to 79. 81 in 80 to 89. 68 in 60 to 69. 84 in 80 to 89. 86 in 80 to 89. Next, 60 in the class 60 to 69. Next, 65 again in the same class. 59 in 50 to 59. 79 in the class 70 to 79. 90 in the class 90 to 99. 51 in the class 50 to 59. Next, 96 is in the class 90 to 99. 103 is in the class 100 to 109. 52 is in the class 50 to 59. 79 is in the class 70 to 79. 50 is in the class 50 to 59. Next, 72 is in the class 70 to 79. Now we will count the tally marks and write the value. So in the first class, the tally mark is 5. Next, it is 5 plus 3, 8. Next, 5 plus 5, 10. Here, 5, 10, 15, 20. 5 plus 3, it is 8. Next, 4. This class is also having 4 strokes, so 4. And last class is having only 1 stroke, so write it back. And make the total. So the total is, when you make the total comes to 60. So this is the continuous frequency distribution of RBHS of workers working in certain factory. And the class intervals, whatever we have used, it is inclusive class interval. So these are the problems under formation of continuous frequency distribution. Now we will see the next concept in this chapter, that is formation of bivariate frequency distribution. bivariate frequency distribution. So far we have seen how to form discrete frequency distribution. Next we have also seen and solved few problems under formation of continuous frequency distribution. Now we will see the formation of bivariate frequency distribution. See, there are certain circumstances where it is necessary to study the two variables at a time or to classify two variables at a time. So for example, if you want to present data of height and weight of students, or income and expenditure of individuals, or ages of husband as well as ages of wife, or even number of children and ages of mothers. So here all these examples contains two variables, and if you want to present both the variables at a time in a frequency distribution, then you may use this bivariate frequency distribution. So what is this bivariate frequency distribution? A frequency distribution formed on the basis of two related variables is called as bivariate frequency distribution. A frequency distribution formed on the basis of two related variables is called as bivariate frequency distribution. By seeing the name, by hearing the name itself, you can make out bivariate. Bi means two, variable means variable. So if you are framing the frequency distribution by considering two related variables like height and weight of students or income and expenditure of individuals, then it is called as bivariate frequency distribution. So while solving the problem under bivariate frequency distribution, first of all you are going to consider two variables, and this two variables, one you can present it as continuous frequency, whereas another you can present it as discrete, or both you can present it in continuous or both in discrete. Next, what you are going to do is you are going to write one variable in column and another variable in row. For example, number of children, you are going to write it in column 0, 1, 2, 3. Next, this is the first variable, number of children. Next, second variable is age of mother. So you can present it in here, that is 20 to 29, next 30 to 39, like this. If you are going to present, then this is called as bivariate frequency distribution. Later on, what you are going to do is you are going to observe the values, two variables value, and mark the stroke in the cell where both the value will lie. For example, number of children is 0 and the age of mother is 24, then it will be marked in the cell where 0 is here, next 24 lies in the class 20 to 29. So where both the values intersect, in that cell you are going to mark the stroke. So in this cell I am going to mark one stroke. Likewise, you are going to mark the stroke in front of the values there it lies. So if it is like this, then you are going to count the tally and write the frequencies in the total column. Then 4. When you make the total of row as well as column, That means if you are going to consider only one variable frequency distribution from this bivariate frequency distribution, then it is called as